We must introduce ourselves, and with you today, my name is Enrique.
My name is Eli.
And my name is Tristan.
Netflix's The Watcher, season one, should only be one.
It better only be one.
Yeah, that's what you think.
All right, one size review, I'll go first. Somehow the BuzzFeed Unsolved video was better than this entire series.
Let me get this one. I thought it was going well, and then it really did not go well.
Super duper poo poo.
I don't know when or where you thought this was going okay, Tristan, but I'm excited for your optimism about things. This shit was over for me in one episode. When I saw homie come out in the Timmy Turner beige outfit, he set the tone for that. I don't know who styled that outfit. That shit was a six pack of ass cheeks.
I received a text from that outfit from Reek going, "What the fuck?"
I was like, "What is he wearing, bro?" And then, don't even get me started. Then the end of the episode has the daughter describing herself as jailbait, and I was like, "Bro, who the fuck wrote this?"
Oh god, the writers of the show.
The episode was when the ferret got killed.
Well, no, towards the end, when the daughter was talking to Dakota, and she goes,
"Don't
talk to me, I'm jailbait." I was like, "What the fuck,
dude?" Whoever wrote this was on fucking meth for sure.
That's generous. They're on a six pack of meth, coke, crystal, fucking black tar.
I'm gonna have to have a talk with
ketamine.
The writer, that's pretty that's pretty creepy to be writing things like that. And then
that's pretty true.
Like the age difference between the two actors is sort of concerning for me, anyways.
I also looked into that because I was confused.
She 19 and he 27.
Yeah, and you gotta think this came out like last year, so they probably filmed when she was like maybe 18. Maybe.
Yeah. Let's chill, Netflix.
I don't give a shit at this point, bro. This shit sucks. Just fucking throw it all away.
Oh my gosh.
They bought this. They paid for the rights for this just because for the sucking story. I don't even know if you have to pay for the rights to this because it's a public domain. Like, it's a, you know, public story or whatever.
Yeah, that's actually true.
But they took this dope-ass concept of getting, like, anonymous threatening letters. And they're like, how can we ruin it? And they did it. It was great. The wife was dog shit. The husband was dog shit. Both little kids were idiots.
The little boy didn't get
any characterization.
He didn't do nothing. Yeah.
Besides making the basketball team.
And
being white and tiny. Like, that was the highlight of it. Like, how do you make it? He's white and small. And he's like, oh, I pass. I play point guard. Like, oh, my God.
No, I thought the husband was okay. Hold on.
No.
Too many times they overdid it. I don't blame him for that. There was a lot of bad writing in this show.
I'm talking about the character. I'm not talking about the actors. I could give a fuck about the actors, to be honest with you.
I blame the writing. I don't blame the character.
When the writing's this fucking bad, I don't see acting anymore. I just see, damn, this is ass.
That's kind of fair. I agree with you, though. The wife was terrible. She
acted fine. That's it. I'm talking about characters.
The daughter.
Worst character.
Oh, my gosh.
Well,
I don't know. I don't even know about
it's
worst
a toss up between
bro.
Her and fucking Dakota, bro. Oh my fucking god!
No, Dakota. He's not the worst character by far.
Through four, he was on episode four. He was.
It was
still
put some respect
daughter.
On my black man's name.
It was
respect,
still
respect.
The daughter.
Put some respect as a child.
Yeah, no. That. I mean, I was unhappy with
you're
that.
You know, Reek, you're defending a pedophile right now.
I hope you know that. Consent law say otherwise.
Okay, in that state. Bro, the law written by creepy white dudes.
He's OJ. He got off. He's acquitted.
All I'm saying is, bro.
He went to the cops. He talked.
I know that.
They say he's cool. And that's the shocking part, really. That was the most unrealistic part of this entire season. The black man was dating a white girl who's underage in New Jersey in the suburbs. He's dead. They were going to shoot him on the spot at that house if this was accurate. Sir, get away from that man. What? No, I'm just talking. Doom, 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 doom. That's the game.
Especially when he made it that big of a point. But then the daughter went and, you know, was like, oh, my dad's a racist.
Oh, don't worry. We already had racial subtext in the episode prior when the fake-ass John Graff showed up. And he was like, oh, I see your daughter's dating African-American. I was like, oh, my God.
See, but that's so the dumb. Thing. Then they decided that, like, this is John Graff.
Well, then, you know, next episode, she does the whole, like, me too, like, my parents are racist, which is great, actually. I love that. That was a great bit. Because, honestly, he was Italian. He probably, you know, he probably a little bit racist, at least.
Little you know bit how Italians get are. Down. Yeah. You've seen God. Italians, French. Like, you're kind of right, but come on.
There's no kind of about it, okay? I speak nothing but truth. What else be happening? Fake ass African American.
Well, the stupid real estate agent was terrible.
Oh, she was. Yeah, that might have been the worst character, actually, now you say that.
Okay, she's
actually.
This doesn't sound mean.
No, it's not. I'll double down on whatever you're about to say.
How can you live your life looking like that?
Absolutely. Yep.
Because she's had so much plastic surgery done to her. She looks like a caricature.
Yeah, and she plays that same character in every fucking movie, every movie or show. I don't know. I guess this was a show. So, yeah, every movie or show. And the thing is, like, that's all she can play because of that choice to do that.
There's got to be some sort of reversion or something they can do. Take, like, a lip filler, move some Botox, something to make her face look more naturally surgery. Her age. Because instead it just looks like she just can't see, like her eyes look permanently locked closed.
Beasting.
And then her lips are like 14 miles long, but then like even with the filler, they're barely like thick, you know what I'm saying?
Right. That's what I'm saying. She looks like she got stung by a bee and she's having an anaphylactic reaction.
And her voice is...
Oh, yeah. Tough.
I'm double checking this because I'm pretty sure that I'm about to be right about this.
It's Jennifer Coolidge. What about it?
Yeah.
She was in Gravity Falls. I knew that.
Yeah, she's fucking one-eyed whatever.
Lazy Susan.
Yeah, sure. That was what it was.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. The voice was...
It makes more sense for a goofy-ass country bumpkin, but it's very irritating to listen to for 7 hours of a Netflix show.
Oh, my God. Yeah, for real. You know, we were talking about bad moments in the show, and the worst written moment might have been, I think it was episode 2, when... Dakota found out their daughter's age, and he's like, "Well, you know, I'm 16, you know," and he's like, "Oh, see, I'm 19. That's not okay." And she goes, "Well, that makes it more fun." And I went,
"Yeah,
come the fuck on, dude."
Yeah, that was a crazy statement right there. She was trying to get him killed. She's the racist one.
This,
she was
this
trying
felt
to get
like
him
this felt like Emmett Till, bro. Like I was like, this is gonna end with him dying. Yeah. Like this has to, and it didn't. And I was confused. And they try to end it all happy, like they're in a relationship now. And I'm like,
Yeah, that was
for real.
That still kind of bugs me that like he was just like, well, the law can't do anything about it, so it's cool.
Then you can be started about the pig, bro. Punk ass pigs again. Oh my God, I hate pigs so much, and every time this happens in TV, they never get their comeuppance, and it's so fucking frustrating. This dude was actively telling them, I'm going to let you get murdered, I don't give a fuck because you annoyed me. Go to the FBI, go to someone higher, we're a boys club, get fucked. I'm like, wow. And they just let him rock, nothing happened to him.
Yeah.
I'm just like, dude, what the fuck, bro? Just kill him. Like, at that point, I would have been cool with the dad just putting his head on the counter, taking out the big ass axe, and chopping his head off on the butcher block.
That's wild.
Get the meat tenderizer. That would have been crazy. Speaking of comeuppance, though, I don't know about you guys. I'm going to skip ahead a small amount.
Sure, dude.
Why did they think that Karen needed, like, I'm so aggravated that they, like, tried to give Karen the business at the very end as if I needed to see that, like as if I was gonna feel better if she got hers, and I just didn't care. Like her dog, she got the house, her dog died, and then she didn't die, but she got scared out of that. Like so ridiculous.
Yeah, why the
dude.
Dog though?
What the dog doing? Because they got the ferret.
Yeah, but like the dog ain't doing nothing wrong.
Let me tell you, I've already assembled this entire story together if you want to hear it. Okay. So, very obviously, the killers weren't who they said they were throughout. It was the Preservation Society of Pearl and fucking fake-ass John Graff, right?
Probably real John Graff based on the way they...
It is real John Graff, but I just call him fake-ass John Graff because they said he wasn't John Graff the entire time.
Yeah.
It's true. Very obvious. They literally try to act like they were way smarter than they were in the show, and it's so upsetting.
Oh God, yeah. That's a great way to put it, because that's exactly the thought I've been having the past week, and I didn't know how to put it into words.
Because the ferret, them killing the ferret makes sense now. Why? Because Preservation Society, what's the ferret going to do to the floors? It's going to fuck up the floors, because it's got claws, it's got shit walking all over there, it's going to fuck up the floor. So why kill the thing? You're killing it to prevent them from fucking up the antique floors, okay? Cool.
Right.
So why would you kill Karen's dog? Same shit. It's going to fuck up the floors with claws. Dogs are, you know, if you have dogs and you have hardwood, you know that that shit happens all the time. There's marks in it.
That, you know, it's a big problem. Just the bathroom on it, you know, not a good thing.
Hair, anything.
Yeah, shit like that. And so that was very obvious, especially once they started doing that and they started hosting it. My issue with that is, if you're going to be cute about it and be like, haha, look, here's the hints that this is the Preservation Society, which there's no hints. It was pretty much obvious that it was the Preservation people, because they're the ones who are sneaking into the house, because that's how Jasper got into there early in the season when they said, oh, the doors are locked. Yeah, Jasper got in through the tunnels. Obviously, it goes to their fucking house. So then later in the season, it was John Graff, because there's a fucking bed down there. Where was he sleeping and where he's living? Oh, he was living down there. That's how he also got into the house. Okay, Preservation Society. Dumb waiter, all this dumb shit. It was so obviously them. They tried their hardest to throw you off that it wasn't. Now, you know, I will say, they did a great job of accurately depicting annoying ass white people in the suburbs. Because they can never let you be happy.
Yeah, that's pretty true.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. The neighbors.
As someone who used to live in the suburbs, shit like this would happen all the time, especially being the only colored people in the suburbs. People would find random shit to come knock on your door and bitch about, or call the cops on you. I got the cops calling us like 4 times because of music that wasn't playing. That was great.
Hell yeah. I will say your opinion's stupid, because at the end they said it's unsolved. So therefore, you're wrong.
That was probably the most frustrating part of this entire show. Because that's when it clicked for me. I was like, BuzzFeed must have paid for this, right? Because if you watch the BuzzFeed Unsolved videos, which are great, by the way, I actually highly recommend those.
They're I don't fuck with BuzzFeed.
Huh?
I don't fuck with BuzzFeed.
Oh, me neither. But that's what I was going to say. It's the only good thing BuzzFeed has ever put out.
Oh, okay,
and it's not
cool.
Because of BuzzFeed. It's because of the two host guys. They're great. Ryan and the other dude. They're fucking amazing.
Shout out to
them. They have great charisma. They're so good. They stopped the show for BuzzFeed, spun off, and made their own channel doing this shit.
Hey, good for them.
That's what I'm saying. Good for them. You know, fuck a BuzzFeed. We hate you, BuzzFeed, you stupid ass, bitch ass, ugly ass, avocado toast eating ass fucking company.
We're just going to say your name 17 times without getting paid for it.
Oh, no, everyone knows them. They know them more than they know us. I mean, psh, I don't give a fuck. Shit, let's burn them down. You know what I'm saying?
I can throw them on the list. We'll get there eventually.
So, but the key thing about that video, those video series of Unsolved, is that at the very end, they would always, the main guy would say, and the mystery of the blank remains unsolved. And I was like, they had to either A, have ripped this entire shit off that video and were stealing it, or B, it was payrolled by BuzzFeed to make this. I couldn't tell which one it was, right?
I could see it.
So yeah. I was just irritated by that ending, because it was them being too smart. They're like, oh, look. It was fucking stupid. Like I said, it made no sense. It's one of the big reasons why the Theodora thing pissed me off.
Was that obvious to you as well when she started telling a stupid story?
Yes. I talked to Eli about this the other day. I said, she was on my watch list because there was things people were finding out that had to have been told by her.
Yes.
Right? So she was obviously a part of it in some case, to where she was snitching a little bit at least. Or there was someone listening in the house. There was one of the two. But I was going when she was snitching, because it seemed like the entire community of the show was in on what was going down.
See,
especially with the ending.
I suspected her the entire show because there was no evidence against her. And I was like, well, there's no reason that, you know, they would like, I didn't know, one, that it was unsolved, or two, that they were going to do the, oh, it's unsolved bullshit. So I was like, oh, they're just going to, you know, have her be the one that's doing it. Because of the fact that there's no evidence against her, and you're always supposed to expect the person that's, you know, not expected. Plus, she's a PI, so. And then as soon as she started explaining, I was like, okay, well, never mind.
Because then it was like, okay, that's cute and all, but she unexplained the ferret. You haven't explained how Jasper gets in there. You don't explain it with the other John Graff guys. Because, like, this is a team effort at that point. And by that point, I knew. I was like, there's more than one motherfucker doing this. It's not. It can't be one guy. So I was just like, whatever, bro. And at that point, like I said, I was suspecting her for 4 episodes. And we got to that. And I was like, oh, it's not her. So by the end, I was like, all right, here's the pieces. These are the pieces. That's how they have to assemble for this to even make any sense. They try to make it seem like the ending is what really, like, the last minute and a half, 2 minutes, is like, I was just done. Because him sending out the extra letters, him going back to the house, staring at the house, talking to the guy who bought the house. Oh, you gotta live around here? Yeah, I live around the neighborhood. Yeah, you're gonna see me some more. Him driving off, talking to the wife. Then the wife came up behind him, pulling up, and while she takes off, they're trying to suggest that they're gonna join the Preservation Society to fuck with the new owners of the house. And I was just like, bro, keep it. Keep it.
Why, dude? I thought that was, like, the coolest part in the show. Especially, like, when he put the weird letter in his mailbox and then the neighbor walked up, like, 5 seconds later with this guy staring at his house just for the guy to get in his car that is outside of the new dude's house, for the new dude to open the mailbox, read a creepy letter from what he can only suspect is the creepy guy looking at his house. Like, what? I don't know, bro. Like, homie, the dad made a phone call in the car to his wife for, like, 2 minutes in the car outside of this dude's house. Like, I don't know. If I'm watching a creepy dude stare at my house and get a creepy letter in the mail, the creepiness is getting, like, you know, those two go together for sure. So why this dude did not knock on his window and be like, hey, you fucking put this in my mailbox? I don't know, man. That shit was wild to me.
And then what were they trying to suggest with the wife watching him do that shit? Or were they trying
that's
to say
a
that
great
she's,
question. I have no idea.
That she's what a part of this, because that's kind of what I got for a minute. I was like, are you saying that she's been on it this whole time?
That's kind of what I was thinking too.
But that was like, this doesn't make sense for that. The best I could offer you is that she started to get on it once the Karen situation happened, to get back at Karen. But it doesn't explain. The big one for me is the stairs issue.
Like that the dude pissed me off.
The dude who popped out of the stairs, and I was like, there's been no suggestion that there was a hidden compartment in the stairs this entire series. Like, what's going on?
Ghost, you know? Bro. Come on now.
Well, and no, that's why that last letter was like, oh, there's so many things about 657 that you're going to find out. All these secrets. I was like, bruh. Like, that's...
And that's why...
That's a cop-out.
Dog shit. Can you... I'll ask you this before we give ratings, because I was genuinely... I was trying to think of what I wanted to give this. And it came down to me asking myself one question, right? Is there a single good part of this TV show?
I legitimately thought that the first 3 episodes provided a decent amount of mystery and curiosity as to what might happen. Then it went all down the drain.
Yeah. I don't know. I felt like that about the pilot. Like, I thought the first episode was pretty good as far as mystery goes, and then after that it was real downhill and I was super hating.
For me, the answer was no.
Hmm.
Oh, sorry. What were you saying, Tristan?
I was going to say, like, for me, 2 and 3, the stuff that made it worse did not have to do with the mystery. It was, like, adding Dakota and the stupid, you know, weird, creepy, older guy plot line and some of that other stuff. Not so much the story line stuff that made it worse until after episode 3.
Well, I'll just tell you, I had like 14 issues with this show after the first episode. All my notes of the first episode are bad. Like, they're all hating on it. Episode 2, I had no notes in general. In episode 3, the only note I had was the fake-ass building instruction really said, African-American boy, that's weird as fuck. So, for me, I was never into the show. Not once I like it. It wasn't even kind of scary. The mystery was fucking stupid. I wasn't entertained by it.
Well, I'm a weenie, so I was kind of scared for a little bit.
This felt like Woman in the House across the street from the girl in the window.
Except not. Ironic.
And honestly, I thought that one was better.
Well, that's impressive, because, again, like I said, those are about the same levels of dog shit, but the woman in the house across the street from the girl in the window, at least.
That had a dope
had
ending.
Had the ending.
Yeah, and at least it ending. Knew it was stupid.
That's what I was trying to figure out. Like, is this show supposed to be a satire? Like, is this making fun of this? And I went and Googled it, and there were some people who thought it was, And some people thought it wasn't. So I was like, so that just means this is bad because you guys can't tell what the point of it is.
Don't you love that?
No. So this thing's a pile of shit. There was no positive moments for it. I would never watch this again. I'm probably going to go watch the BuzzFeed video after this and be like, oh, look, this is what they could have did. This thing's a piece of shit again. The acting was fine. I won't hate on the actors. Again, this is mostly on the writers. Look, if y'all are going to do a writer's strike, Writers Guild of America, y'all gotta figure out what's up with the quality of this shit. I don't know what's going on. I heard that the last person you guys are waiting for are Netflix. Netflix, you want to pay these guys, because if these are the non-guild guys, shit, pay the guild, bro. Pay the guild. Workers' rights.
It's a reminder that the, what was it, 1877 or whatever, the 1889, that one got canceled.
Yeah, they don't want, because they don't want to pay fucking money, piece of shit ass, bitch ass, ugly ass Netflix. But then they want to make shit like this. You can make this, but you cancel Teenage Bounty Hunters? Come on, bro.
I'm so they want to make you pay for two accounts, too.
Yeah, they did, like, oh, you can't watch outside your house. What you mean I can't watch outside my house? They said, no password sharing. I'm like, bitch, I'll cancel. Bet I won't. Oh, you catch me at the library every day. So, yeah, man. Ratings, and my rating for it is 2.
Also 2.5.
3.
They're lucky I didn't go lower, to be honest. But like my scale is fucked by Bloodlines and Death Note movie.
Yeah, that's pretty true. Well, we gave some a 0. We gave 0 on Bloodlines, yeah.
And I think we gave Death Note movie 1. So that's about the scale of it. Yeah, thanks for hanging out with us today. I don't got much else to say. Oh, wait. Sorry, guys. Can't do that just yet. We got to figure out what our next TV show is. Right.
And our movie for next week, don't we? Or do we already have
It's Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania, right, dumbass.
You're right.
Tell him again.
Dumbass.
So we're either watching two shows that we're like a month late on, so that's nice, because these came around the same time. We're either watching Beef starring my dog, Steven Yeun, or watching The Night Agent starring some guy who looks like the guy from Blue Mountain State, but is not the guy from Blue Mountain State. You want to talk about that, Castle?
Yeah, because he was
Alan Richardson.
He was Jack Reacher in the show that they made.
God damn it. My own show won. I'm not even happy about it. So we're watching Night Agent. So that's going to be fun in 2 weeks' time. You can hang out with us next week when we talk about Ant-Man and the Wasp to conclude our... Oh, Ant-Man and the Wasp 3 to conclude our fucking Marvel catch-up shit. So we're caught up on most of the MCU movies at this point, even though half of them suck. But Guardians of the Galaxy 3, fire.
Don't ask for Marvel, Miss Marvel and the Marvel sons.
We're going to watch the
number
Marvels,
two.
I'm sorry.
We're going to watch Miss Marvel.
We ain't watching them. We ain't watching Miss Marvel. We ain't watching Captain Marvel. We ain't watching none Marvels.
We also got to do Secret Invasion when that comes out. So that's like next month, I think. Or this month. So, yeah. Thanks for hanging out with us today. We have a good time. We remind you guys got social media. You can find us on Twitter at BINGBOIS. You can find us on Instagram at DABINGBOIS. That's D instead of the, because we are dumb asses. You can also find us on TikTok at the same at, which is once again at DABINGBOIS. Yes, we had a decent time with you guys this week, but we got to go and do our own thing, much like the High School Musical cast in High School Musical 2. So, I want to remind you guys that with you today, my name was Enrique.
My name was Eli.
And my name is Tristan.
And I want you to remember, I'm watching you.